We confirm that after the death of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Khalifas went first to the Khilafah went first to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. May Allah accept his deeds, thus proving his excellence and superiority over the rest of the Muslims. So this is part of our aqidah, that the Khilafah went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, and this is the right Khilafah. So those who come and say from the Rawafid that Abu Bakr took the Khilafah from Ali, it was supposed to go to Ali, and it was he took it out of his right and so on, that's, we don't believe in that. We believe that the Khilafah went to the right person, which is Abu Bakr, which is the right person or the righteous person of the Ummah after the Prophet ﷺ. There are different opinions among the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah concerning the question of what the basis was for the Khilafah of Abu Bakr Siddiq. So what is the basis that it is the right Khilafah? Was it by textual evidence or by selection? So is it something in the Book of Allah? Or it is because a Muslim selected him in the gathering that happened after the death of the Prophet? Al-Hasan al-Basri and the group of the Hadith scholars say that it is implied and suggested by verses, by various texts. Others say that it is clearly established by the text. Al-Bukhari from Jubayr ibn Mur'im says that a woman came to the Prophet ﷺ asking for something, but he sent her back and asked her to come again. She said, "If I come back and do not find you, what should I do?" As if she thought he might die. The Prophet ﷺ replied, "If you don't find me, go to Abu Bakr." This is a hadith in Bukhari. It says clearly that the Prophet ﷺ is telling her that the leader after me is going to be Abu Bakr. That's in the text. Implication that the Khilafah should go to Abu Bakr. Follow the examples of those who will come after me, Abu Bakr and Umar. This is an authentic hadith. So the Prophet ﷺ says about Abu Bakr first. Sahih Bukhari and Muslim have a hadith narrated by Aisha as well as her father Abu Bakr, that the Prophet ﷺ came to her the day he fell ill and asked her to call her father and brother so that he could dictate a will to the former. Then he said, "Allah and the Muslims will never accept anyone other than Abu Bakr." This hadith is in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. This was related to the Prophet ﷺ asking Aisha to ask Abu Bakr to pray with the people, where she said he is weak, and the Prophet ﷺ went unconscious, he woke up. "Did you ask Abu Bakr to pray with the people, imam with the people?" She said, "No." He said, "You are the friends of Yusuf. Ask Abu Bakr to pray as an imam with the people. Allah and his men, the Muslims, will never accept anyone other than Abu Bakr." So that was in the text that actually the Khilafah of Abu Bakr was the true Khilafah. The two Sahihs also have a hadith reported by Abu Huraira that the Prophet ﷺ said, "I saw in a dream that I was at a well and there was a bucket there. I took it and drew as much water from the well as Allah wanted me to draw. Then Abu Bakr took the bucket from me and drew once or twice. He was a little weak in drawing, but Allah will forgive him. Then the bucket grew larger, and Ibn al-Khattab took it from him. I never saw a man gigantic like him. He drew so well that everyone drank his fill." You can feel it. How the Prophet ﷺ spoke about the future of Abu Bakr when he said, "Drew once or twice." Can you say a year or two, which is the Khilafah of Abu Bakr, 2 years plus a couple of months? And then speaking about Umar, how he drew a lot and how Islam expanded and established and all the financial system and everything was established at his time. And this is a hadith in the two Sahihs. In Sunan Abu Dawud and other works, there is a hadith reported by Aisha from Al-Hasan on the authority of Abu Bakr that one day the Prophet ﷺ asked the people, who has seen a dream? One man said, I have. I saw that a balance came down from the sky. You and Abu Bakr were weighed, and you outweighed Abu Bakr. Then Abu Bakr and Umar were weighed, and Abu Bakr outweighed Umar. Then Umar and Uthman were weighed, and Umar outweighed Uthman. Then the balance was lifted. Abu Bakr says that at that moment, he looked at the Prophet's face, and he was unhappy. He said, this was the Khilafah on the pattern of prophetic rules, ala manhaj al-Nubuwa. Allah will then hand over the government to whom He pleases. This means that according to the Prophet ﷺ, the Khilafah of these three Khalifas was on the pattern of prophetic government. Then come the monarchy. Ali is not mentioned in this hadith because people did not agree on one ruler during his time and were divided. There was neither a Khilafah on the prophetic pattern nor a monarchy. At the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib, Muawiyah, Egypt, all of that area did not give bay'ah to Ali ibn Abi Talib. That's why the hadith, the dream, showed three only. Had he thought that his preference for Abu Bakr was not clear to the Ummah, he would have declared it clearly and explicitly. Since he made his preference very clear and people had got it, the purpose was served. So the Prophet ﷺ did not need to clearly assign Abu Bakr is the Khalifa after me. Because there were lots of texts and lots of incidents that showed that Abu Bakr need to be after the Prophet ﷺ. Two Sahihs also have the hadith reported by Abu Darda that he was sitting with the Prophet ﷺ when Abu Bakr came, lifting a corner of his gown so that his knees were exposed. Seeing him, the Prophet ﷺ said to the people around, it seems that your friend has had a dispute. Abu Bakr greeted them and said, Messenger of Allah, something happened between me and Umar ibn al-Khattab. I rushed to him, expressed my regrets and begged his pardon, but he refused to pardon me. That is why I have come to you. The Prophet ﷺ said, may Allah forgive you, Abu Bakr, and repeated the words three times. Umar then felt very sorry and went to Abu Bakr's house to inquire about him. He was told that Abu Bakr was not at home. Then he went to the Prophet ﷺ and greeted him. The Prophet ﷺ face turned grave. Abu Bakr saw it and got up on his knees and said, Messenger of Allah, by Allah, I was the one who was in the wrong. He said it twice. So Abu Bakr was trying to defend who? Umar al-Khattab. So that the Prophet ﷺ does not become angry from Umar. Whereupon addressing the people around him, the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah sent me as a messenger to you and you denied me. But Abu Bakr bore witness that I was truthful. Who denied him? Umar at the beginning. But Abu Bakr accepted him. He also helped me with his money and his person. Will you not leave my friend for me? Will you not leave for my friend for me? Thereafter, Abu Bakr was never harmed anymore. All of these narrations to show that Abu Bakr, by the text, is the first Khalifa, authentic Khalifa, and this is in our Aqidah.